Hello everyone, it's Richard Ryder. Making a response to you, and basically the name of this video is There Is No Black Gender War. Now, I say this. You have a question for me, why is it a problem when black women do the same? It's not a problem when black women do the same. The problem is this, and listen very carefully. When a black female is young, she has an option in her life. Excuse me. That one option is this. Go to school and get to a normal or a basic or average level of intelligence. If she can do this, she can find a decent black male. But the problem lies in our media, in our society, where little black girls are taught they have to have the best of the best. There is a video on YouTube, why are 42% of black females single? And they talked to Steve Harvey, and he made one basic point. You girls are too picky to be picky. You want a guy who is 6'6". You want a guy who's 6'6", who has a bachelor's and two undergrads and social science and European studies. I mean, you want ridiculous things. Some of y'all just want Obama. Instead of sitting back and growing with a man before he's a man, let's say a young man. No, that's not an option for a lot of you females. You want someone who is already self-made, stuck in their ways. I'm not sure what to really call it. I think in some aspects, it's like you want to be a princess. And that princess mentality, no one is really going for. So, if you're a princess, and you know what, you need to have a man who has all these criterias, this is the reason why you see a lot of guys who are attractive, good-looking men, and they date females that are not on their level, because they see that when you're beautiful, or let's say 8+, you have ridiculous standards. The way you want to be treated, the way you perceive the world is not normal. And what I mean by normal in this context, I'm using the word, is consistent. If an alien were to come to Earth and ask for the human experience, and if you sit back and talk about how you can see the world and eat all kinds of exotic foods and meet people and just have the best of stuff, you would be lying. Because 75 or 85% of the world is poor or below poverty. The human experience is about suffering. It's about not having. It's about determined to get to the next day, determined to see the light. There is a lot of anxiety we go through because we don't have enough money. We don't have enough money to take care of ourselves. We don't have enough money to eat the best food we want to eat. We don't get to do what we want to do. Education is not always available to us. And then when we do get education, is it correct education or is it miseducation or education that is lacking? Or something that was educated. And that's the human experience. So if you're trying to find a mate and she feels that she's so privileged, and I come from the human experience, why would I want to be with a beautiful female? Do you get me? And a lot of black females like to say a certain thing where they say, oh, you can't handle a strong black woman. And that's a foolish statement for the simple reason, why should I have to handle a woman? You're not a tool. You're not a job. You're not a career. You're a person. Now, if you're saying you're not strong enough to handle situations that might be thrown our way, you know, what happens if we have a handicapped child or our son might be gay? Okay, that is a valid argument. And I would not sit there and deny any female from making that statement when she talks to a guy, says, listen, you're a weak man. You can't handle real life problems. And the reason why we say handle is because the human experience is, it deals with struggle. It deals with anxiety. But the females today, they sit back and they go for the quick fix. The quick fix is the thug. From the age of 16 to 24, they sit back and they get with this one dude who's sitting there selling drugs on the corner. And that guy doesn't have any sort of decent education because he knows it's a short lifespan. He's going to end up going to jail. And then he's going to sit there and say all that little sweet nonsense in her ears. Baby, I love you. I don't want to use a condom. Condoms are for faggots. Real men don't pull out. All kinds of nonsense to get into that young girl's mind. And you know what? She ends up with a child. And that woman who had the potential to do all kinds of things with her life now has to sit there and sacrifice her life to her child. Yes, it's a blessing, but why would you want to make that kind of sacrifice? A real man knows that if a woman had certain types of desires and abilities, he would inspire her to do everything possible to sit back and see his wife get to the next level. Now, I'm not going to sit there and jump on that European angle where men's supposed to work and women's supposed to stay at home. No, I'm saying if a man can sit there and handle every single situation that is thrown upon him, especially your career, well then, hey, that's a good catch. But the thug is not about that. That's why the video prior to this was thugs don't care, they get pussy. Now, a lot of females have this other issue. And this happens in the black culture a lot. Due to the fact that we have always been every man for themselves. And that's the reason why we are in the boat that we are in. You know you have education. You know you can sit back and say something to someone's head, inspire them to do better. I'm not going to get on that idea that when you talk, the next person is not influenced. That's a foolish assumption. It's foolish to assume that they won't be, and it's foolish to assume that they will be. Words are power. It says in the Bible, the sweetest thing in this world is your tongue. And the sharpest thing than any sword in this world is your tongue. So guard your tongue. If there is not a male in the house, how do females know what a decent male is? If a little girl grows up without a father, who is to blame, the mother or the father? Now I have this little clip where Judge Judy is going to talk to these three women. And listen to what she says.
Who do you live with?
By myself and my children.
Who do you live with?
By myself and my children.
Where are the fathers of these seven children? Anywhere?
Yes. Yeah.
You have children?
No, ma'am.
Perfect. Sit down. You have children?
Yes.
How many?
One.
How old?
Three.
Where's his father?
In jail.
Okay. I'll deal with this in a second. First, I'll get the social part of this off my chest. Between the three of you, you have eight children. No fathers around. Mothers who are either marginally employed, going to some technical school where they can become a nurse to save people while out there brawling in parking lots. And I don't know what you do. All I can tell you is these eight children didn't ask to be born. And what they do is they are entitled to at least one parent to set a good example. One parent to put them in a place in the world where they can say, look, I grew up with a reasonable role model, and that's what I want to be. I want to be like my mother, because all three of you picked losers to father these children, because none of them are around. So you made bad judgments eight times. You have to start acting like a grown-up. Grown-ups take care of their children. They don't only provide them with food. They provide them with a moral compass. They try not to teach them to grow up to being brawling animals in parking lots, hitting each other with 2x4s, scratching each other, vandalizing cars. Human beings don't do that to each other. Put your hand down. You don't belong out at a club 12:30 at night when you have a 1-year-old, a 2-year-old, a 5-year-old, and a 12-year-old. You belong home. Reading them stories from a book. Do you understand?
Joanna, I understand.
Perfect.
So here you see an educated woman who has went to school, got her law degree, who is a reasonable thinker, clearly said that you picked these men. So, for the females that may not go to higher education, don't sit there and throw your life away with guys who are beneath you. There are plenty of guys in college that would love to date a decent female. You don't have to be the next female president. You don't have to be the next Michelle Obama. You just have to be decent. Keep your body right. Know how to carry on a basic conversation. Read. Have some sort of intelligence. But everyone is caught up in the bad girls club, black people at their worst, Hotlanta, black people at their worst, the love of hip-hop whores, black people at their worst, and we're glorifying this foolish behavior. If I was a white man and I turned on the television and I saw this, I would think, wow, when black girls have no money, they act like this. When they get money, they act the same way.